just something you can't avoid. But one thing nobody can avoid right now is this next match here.
Okay, so opting to stay with the Bowser. This is actually going to be interesting, too, because as we've seen players like Nairo opting to go Bowser against Mr. R and company, Sheik suffers very heavily in this type of matchup with especially the fact that she just cannot kill.
Yeah.
And you're going to give Bowser all that rage, but it's also dependent on Bowser's ability to play center stage control.
Exactly. If he gets off stage, Sheik's going to have a field day, mm-hmm. and she's going to need to. Look at this. Immediately, as soon as he gets center stage, mm-hmm. going for needles. That's just something you have to do.
Suar's playing perfect defense right now, too. Like, he's and getting a follow-up bouncing fish, too.
Yeah, just these small committal options that Zoo's putting out, just getting sniped out. I mean, that's what makes a good Sheik player, mm-hmm. you know, just separates them from the rest.
We are in Sheik syndrome range now, though, because he has to steal out the stock, because all Zoo needs is about another 50%. But he is just not letting Zoo, like, he's not letting Zoo play.
Oh my gosh, and that fair, you know, just putting him at 48, this, it could be a pretty soon. I feel like a bit more rage.
But just throwing out noticing that he was just kind of like free fall on there.
Yeah.
Like, all right, he's nowhere near me. He's not going to do anything. Throws out that down B and gets the stock.
Yeah, just great awareness from Swart. Nice little read overall. And Zoo just looking like he just needs to do something.
Yeah,
and he's just getting hit too much. He's respecting Sheik too much. It's just what happens. Not a character that you have to just stay in shield on.
In his defense, too, on the fact that he hasn't been able to do much, Suarez is playing this match like perfectly so far.
Yeah,
he is not lit. Oh, it doesn't mash on his recovery there either. Suarez taking a very dominant game one there on FD, which was the perfect stage for him, too, because now he can harass his landing as much as he wants, which is the issue that Bowser has in this matchup.
Yeah.
And he just did not, like, he truly barely let him play that match.
Yeah,
like, he played it perfectly. Like, you want to
really
be able
commentate
to
commentate on Zoo. She was doing much. Now,
but he gets access to Town and City.
Yeah, Town, just a great stage overall, especially for Bowser.
Mm-hmm. He has the ability to be a little bit more evasive with the platforms now, too. Get those side B kills up top. But more importantly, that up throw to up air killing super early.
Wow, those the multi-judge is jabbing right out of that. A couple up Bs.
I like
him the small lead. Maybe it's just the adjustment he needs just to throw out some random stuff.
I like what he's doing. He's been playing like some good hard defense against Suar right now. And
yeah,
actually has
a
good percent lead. And this might seal this out.
Not yet.
Pretty close.
Yeah. I guess another one definitely do it. Whoa.
Oh. Like, I like the idea, but
frame data.
Yeah, frame data not really coming through in the clutch for you there.
I was thinking of something else there, but
he's been opting for a backer, like trying to catch a roll like in a couple times now. So he needs to be very careful with that. But Suar bringing this right back.
Yeah, too aggressive on that get up attack. I'm gonna punish. Oh, and that fair. Will that do it? No.
Luckily,
drops the edge guard.
All right, we're at a very scary position right now because both these characters at kill percent. The Uppy's not gonna do it, but it gets him off of him very well.
Oh,
just barely
missed
with that down tilt.
Very strange situation. Both these players are going to want the kill, like, right now.
I like what Zoo's been trying to do with this whole, like, fastball back airs to, like, get some, like, cancel his aerial momentum. But he's been landing center stage with it, and you're very likely to get punished for it. So he's got to be very careful with that. But Suar, once again, doing a great job edgeguarding him. And
that's
Zoo still living, actually.
Well, max rage on Bowser. Better be ready. Oh, wow. Bouncing fish. Not going to...
Luckily, not getting punished for it either.
Yeah, sheesh. That was a very messy situation, to say the least. Now some Sheik syndrome on the stage with the early ceilings.
Good job on Suar, but like as soon as he rolled, immediately threw out the jab to avoid getting punished.
Yeah, now fair almost killing, funnily enough. That Nair, gonna push him off.
Oh my god, that, he's been going for that all day, and it looks so good each time he does it. Managing to get that wall bounce bouncing fish, and still managing to not die. Never mind. Didn't die off of that fair trade before, but I am just a king of doing that. If I compliment anybody, they die.
You should just compliment my bank account.
Compliment your bank account?
Disrespect my bank account. I need some money in there.
All right, I got you.
College students, oh, we all need that money.
Shout outs to trying to be a college student nowadays.
Yeah, no, it's a rough time. But I mean, just in the matter of, like, I don't know, seconds.
Oh, he got the air dodge read with that up
finishes.
B. Very good stuff. Look at my position. I look like... I wasn't even thinking about it until I saw it. I was like...
Okay, I guess.
Looks like I'm getting banned from. I'm probably gonna get banned from here. No dabbing on stream.
I'm sorry, you had to see this at the grid.
Oh, I know. Yeah, I'm absolutely not the first one to do that. But shout out to PM Weeklies. Yeah, we said it. They host it here, so we can say it. Shout out to Project Man and Melee and Injustice 2, which I will be talking to you afterwards about. So we are going to go back onto Town and City. Got a color counterpick, so no more Super Saiyan Boozer. We're going to go with
the Hulk Smash variation of Bowser. But the Tinder Stripes is going to get him off stage. He's going to have to get something quick.
One of the big things that you have to think about when you're playing against this kind of matchup is that no matter what, this damage is going to happen. When you play against a character like Sheik, you have to accept that you're going to eat, well, I mean, unfortunately, he's at 93% now, but you're going to eat those, like, bread and butters that's going to bring you to 40, 50%. And again, gets him with the wall bounce, bouncing fish. And, all right, so as I'm sitting there trying to talk about how to deal with this matchup, Swar making it look like it's not doable at all.
Oh, my gosh, such an aggressive down air. He's trying to make a statement.
He has a stock lead, so he can fool around a bit with that. Like, it's working out very well. Actually, he has a two-game lead and a stock lead, so... Looking very grim for Zoo at the moment, and Swar just not let, like, he's just playing right out of his range. Nice up, he had a shield to put, get some pressure off of him, but looking very, very dark for our big grappler at the moment. That almost sniped him out, playing off stage a little bit.
And now just Zoo trying to put out anything, and shield a bit too much now, getting grabbed because of it, getting these small trades.
Oh my god. When you have a stock to play with, why not? Like, wait, when you're up a stock like that and it's such a huge lead, and like, why not?
That looked kind of rough.
Yeah, game three, very dominant in Suarez fashion and sealing that out. And I believe Suarez is going to be waiting for... Actually, yeah, Suarez is going to be playing immediately. He's going to be playing Losers Finals against Bellic.
Yeah, let's see what Bellic can do. Do you think he's going to...